Hello everyone and welcome to another video. In this video, I'll be giving a brief overview of one of our Comset 5G dual SIM routers, the CM950W. So let's begin by taking a look at what's included with this router.
So inside the box, you'll receive your Comset CM950 router, as well as a Cat5e Ethernet cable, a serial cable, a 12-volt DC power supply with an adapter for the terminal block, two Wi-Fi antennas, four 5G cellular antennas, and a couple of mounting brackets for mounting on the wall or a desk. Next, let's take a look at the SIM cards for this router. When you first get your SIM card, it should look something like this. To get it out of the packaging, simply push it out. Now, this here is the standard size SIM, sometimes called a mini or regular SIM. And if we look closely, we can see that it can also be adapted to a micro or a nano size SIM, with a nano size being the most common size today. However, inserting a micro or nano SIM into the SIM slots on the CM950 can actually damage the SIM slots, so it's really important that we only use the standard size SIM cards in this router. To insert the SIM card into the router, we'll need something small to push in the button next to the SIM slot. I usually use a small screwdriver for this. So push the button down until the tray pops out, then gently slide it out of the router. Place the SIM in the tray with the chip side up. And then carefully push the tray back in, making sure to keep this as flat as possible. If you push it in on an angle, you can end up damaging the SIM slot or losing the SIM into the router. Okay, so push it all the way in as far as it will go. Now you might have noticed the CM950 has two SIM slots. You can absolutely use this router with just the one SIM card. If this is the case, make sure that you place your SIM into SIM slot 1. If you happen to have two SIM cards, SIM slot 2 is exactly the same as SIM 1, however the tray is upside down. So if I open the tray and take it out, and place our second SIM in with the chip facing up again, to put it back in, I'll flip the tray over so the chip is now facing down, and then push it in all the way, being careful not to put it in on an angle. One advantage of having two SIM cards over having just the one SIM card is you can use it for failover redundancy. This means that if the first SIM card fails, whether it's damaged or the network goes down, the router will automatically switch over to using the second SIM card instead. So now let's have a look at the Wi-Fi and cellular capabilities of this router.
As I mentioned before, the CM950 comes with two Wi-Fi antennas, which you can attach at the front, here, and here. Now this Wi-Fi meets the AC standard, so it can provide Wi-Fi at both the 5 GHz and the 2.4 GHz frequencies. This means you can choose between having the benefits of a wider range of coverage from using the 2.4 GHz, or from having the higher speeds that the 5 GHz Wi-Fi offers. This router also comes with four 5G cellular antennas, which attach with two at the front and two at the back. Now the CM950 only supports 4x4 MIMO, unlike our 4G routers, which only support 2x2. This means that you need to connect all four antennas to the router. If you find that the provided antennas don't offer a strong enough signal in your area, you can choose to attach external high gain antennas instead. Now to attach one of these antennas, simply twist it until it is nice and secure. And then with these ones, you just bend them up like so. Lastly, let's have a look at the other physical interfaces of the CM950 router. First up, let's take a look at the front of this router. So here we have four LAN Ethernet ports. We have two for fast Ethernet and two for gigabit Ethernet, which offers faster speeds. Now, all four of these LAN ports can be used to connect to devices on your local network, such as to your PC, or to devices like IP cameras. And these two fast Ethernet ports also support passive power over Ethernet. This means that you can power the router via either of these Ethernet ports with a supply voltage of 12 or 24 volts DC using a power over Ethernet adapter. Next, here we have one WAN port for connecting to external networks like the NBN. You can also configure this to act as a LAN, as I've covered in another video. Then underneath this, we have a console port. This is used to connect directly to the router for management. However, you shouldn't ever need to use this. And then over here underneath cell 2, we also have a USB 3 port. This could be used for a variety of things, such as establishing shared storage across the network. Then on the side of this router, we have a terminal block. So from right to left, we have a VCC pin and a ground pin for the power supply. VCC can be connected to a supply voltage of between 5 and 40 volts DC, and ground must be connected to the ground of this power supply. The terminal adapter that's provided in the box has these connected already. We strongly recommend using the provided power supply because applying the incorrect polarity can seriously damage the router. Now you can also use the terminal block for serial communication using the RS-232 standard. So for this we have the three pins here. There's TX, RX, and ground. Be careful not to confuse the ground of the serial communication with the ground for the power supply. Next along we have the reset pin. You can use this to reset the router to the factory default by shorting this pin to the ground pin of the power supply for 3 seconds. However, there is also a button on the front here that you can hold down for 12 seconds to also reset the router to factory default. Finally, on the terminal block, we have 4 pins for general purpose digital input and output. All 4 of these pins can be configured as either inputs connected to some kind of sensor, or outputs connected to things like lights or motors. Okay, so that is all of the physical interfaces on this router. Okay, so that is a basic overview of the CM950W router. If you'd like to learn more about configuring this router or setting up specific features like VPNs or port forwarding, be sure to check out our other tutorial videos. So that's all for this video. Thanks for watching. See you in the next one.